Hello everyone and Happy New Year! In this short video, I'll show you how to get sharper stars with the Dwarf II smart telescope. If you don't have yet a Dwarf II telescope and you want to buy one, you can use the affiliate link in the description and the discount code GAM, which will give you a 5% discount on the price. For more information, check the video description. If you are already using a Dwarf II telescope, you probably noticed on your astrophotography images that the stars don't look so good. They look bloated, very bright, and also the images look very blurry. You may question why is this happening. This happens because you are using the Dwarf II with the default settings in the DwarfLab app. And to be specific, with the IR pass filter enabled or IR cut filter off. Having the IR pass enabled will allow the infrared light to get to the imaging sensor of the Dwarf II telescope. While this can have some benefits in boosting the light that the Dwarf II can capture in a single exposure, has also a big drawback. And you'll end up with images that look out of focus, blurry, and with bad-looking stars. So to solve this problem, you need to enable the IR cut filter so the infrared light will be blocked, allowing the Dwarf II telescope to capture images with good focus and sharp stars. As I mentioned in the beginning, the IR pass option has also some benefits, allowing you to capture more light. So should you disable IR pass all the time or use both options? Also IR cut and IR pass. I have tested two nights these options on nebulas, galaxies and star clusters to be able to show you the difference and answer this question. So if you do want to know how to use these settings properly and get the best images with Dwarf II, check also this video tutorial where I will show you when to use the IR cut and IR pass options. And compare the images side by side so you can understand better how to use this setting to get the best images from your Dwarf II telescope. Don't forget to check the full tutorial and share and like this video if you enjoyed watching. And I'll see you in the next part of the video.